this leg, neither. No work tomorrow.
That's not the problem. We finish tomorrow. We get our money.
Oh, good. Well, see me the toilet, do you, sweetheart?
Oh, thank you.
I don't
see. Listen, look in a moment.
Hello, Dinesh.
Andy here. DL. Yeah, that's right, yeah. Look, can I have the same as usual, please? Or this time, I'll just have one naan bread and one stuffed paratha. Yeah, yeah. Oh, well, can I have one of them puddings with a name that I can never pronounce? That's it. Aye. All right, I'll see you in a bit. Yeah. Ta-da.
Oh, thanks for coming, mate.
It's no problem.
Go back a long way, me and you, don't we, eh?
Yeah, we do.
You know, I got a lot of mates in army and all that. But you knew me when we were kids. And that's why I wanted you here, because, like, we were kids together, you know what I'm saying?
Yeah.
Wilkie! Pete Pascoe? Me Corporal Martin Wilkie. Dual-link crown at Yorkshire Royal Fusiliers and also one hell of a good mate.
So, your Terry tells us you're a copper. Is that true?
Well, I didn't want my mates getting into trouble. You know what stag do is like.
Ah, so, you are a copper.
His dad couldn't keep him on farm.
Not for the last 18 years, anyway.
Fancy having a copper as your best man, eh?
You got a problem with that?
No, it could come in useful. He could bring his ankles in case the brine gets stuck in the throat.
Come.
Beautiful. Just like your mother.
We just want to see your passport and papers. Immigration.
Can I see your passport, please? Where have you come from?
Portugal.
From Portugal.
Portugal?
Speak Portuguese to me. Say something Portuguese. Would you like to come with me, please? Thank you.
Save us a few bob.
We am a shadow rolling down the avenue.
Hey, I saw that, lad.
Sorry, I'm just worried about getting Ian back. Part of my job.
They're used to the odd pint, they are, eh?
But I'm glad you can be with us. Pleasure.
Pity you couldn't get your dad out, miserable old bugger.
You know what he's like.
We're alone but far from blue!
What the hell are you doing, you fat pig? Bloody hell, eh? I don't want to be crushed today. passcode. Whee! Huh? Is that why you couldn't hack it in the army? Huh? Because you're a fat pig.
Hey, steady, lads! Terry, get off! Leave it! Leave it! Will, come on! Martin! Martin!
Yeah. Whoa, look at me, look at me. Come on.
Hello?
Wildy?
Sir?
Is something wrong?
No, Wildy. I just thought I'd give you a call to make sure you knew what time you were picking me up tomorrow.
About 9, you said?
Yeah. Well, the appointment's not till 10, but you know what these consultants are like. First sign of a mix-up and the buggers will be doodling on your belly with a felt-tip pen.
Yes, sir.
It won't take too long, mind. It's just routine, nothing special. Half an hour, I'll be out with a couple of nurses helping them brush up on their anatomy.
Best get some sleep.
I need you to be on the ball come tomorrow morning. Night, Wildy.
Night, sir.
Oh, and,
thanks.
Today? What, you'll be getting ready for your sister's wedding?
Can't afford to take a day off, Mr. P.
You're a bridesmaid, aren't you?
Yeah, I'm Megan.
Oh, I don't suppose you remember our Peter, do you? Peter, look who's here. Kate Lowry.
Kate? I didn't recognise you. That's been years.
I'd have been about 8 when we last met. I remember you, though. You haven't changed. I'll see you later, then.
Yeah. So how long's Kate Lowry been your postman?
She's only been doing it a couple of months.
Oh, she's not helping her dad, then?
Not her cup of tea, farming.
Dad? How long are you staying, then? Well, just for tonight, I thought.
It's been a long time since we last saw you.
Things have certainly changed. Foot and mouth.
Nearly finished us. Had to lay all the lads off. Cousin Terry here worked without pay.
You know Peter would have come if he could. You wouldn't let anybody in here.
Well, we had to seal the place up, didn't we? We weren't going to lose our herd after all the years we've spent building them up.
From what I heard, you were luckier if you got it.
I would never wish that on my stock.
Jack Henslow got it. And Ted Lowry.
Oh, aye, they really cleaned up. Probably made Ted Lowry a millionaire. But then he always did know how to make a few bob, didn't he? I'll have a bet with you now. He never paid them foreign workers they picked up at his place last night.
What was that?
Immigration went down again. Rounded up 30 of the poor buggers. Just got the last of the spuds in.
Oh, you mean he phoned it in himself?
Of course he did.
Why the old bugger?
What we're seeing here is a T-wave inversion on some of the ECG leads, and there's some ventricular ectopics.
In English, Doctor. I haven't got any euros in my pocket yet.
That means there's a slight abnormality with regard to the electrical impulses that make the muscle cells in your heart work.
I know I'm a bit out of shape, but as soon as I get the diet sorted and start walking next to those collie, I'll be as right as rain.
Kate, about time. Stop panicking, I'm here, aren't I?
Well, get a move on.
Don't want you holding things up.
I'll be ready. Ooh!
Haven't seen you in a dress for years.
Yeah, well, now we know why.
Look like Miss Piggy.
Miss Piggy!
Very funny. At least I'm ready.
Oh, God, the ugly sisters.
Gail, want a word with you. And Megan.
What for?
Never mind. Come through here.
What about me?
You get ready.
Dad, just sit down, please.
Megan.
I don't believe you could do this.
Megan, please, just calm down.
What's going on?
Come on, Kate, let's go.
What's the matter with her?
She doesn't want my wedding present from Dad.
What?
You'll see. Well, what do you think? You haven't said anything yet?
You look lovely.
Ooh, egg! Look, my cat's dragged it. Megan Lowry in a posh frock. Pigs will be flying then. All right, Megan.
So, who's going to catch the bouquet then?
Oh, I think that'll be Kate. It'll be a waste of our time if it's Meg.
Grow up, Martin.
We're on. Here goes.
Good luck, then.
Couldn't help thinking of your mother, you in that dress.
With this ring I thee wed.
With this ring I thee wed.
With my body I thee worship.
With my body I thee worship.
And with all my worldly goods I thee endow.
And with all my worldly goods I thee endow.
In the name of the Father.
In the name of the Father.
And of the Son.
And of the Son.
And of the Holy Ghost.
And of the Holy Ghost.
Amen.
Amen.
How did it go, sir?
That's the MOT, Wieldy. Good for another million smiles. Must be all that muesli to keep me regular.
Thanks, honey. I think so too.
He still misses her, his wife. Don't think he's ever got over it.
She died having Kate, didn't she?
Mm. Poor girl. Imagine having to live with that.
Ladies and gentlemen, well, ladies at any rate, I'd like to thank you all for coming, of course, and being with us on such an auspicious day. Not only Irene and Jill joined together, but also one day when Ian's decided to hang up his sword and Jack's had enough of it.
Hey, I'm not done yet.
Well, the two farming families, the Henslows and the Lowrys, will join together as one farm. That'll make us one of the biggest farms in the county. Hang on, I've not finished. Now, today, I'm retiring from running Dalebrook Farm. The land, the buildings, the stock, the machinery, the whole lot, I'm passing on to my daughter, Jill. Now, this decision has partly been influenced by another piece of good news. Our Jill, and I know she won't mind me saying this, is pregnant. Yeah, she's in calf.
Ian!
Is that what Dad was saying to you this morning? He's giving the whole lot to Jill?
Pretty much.
Do you mean pretty much?
Well, I get some. About a quarter of what he's worth.
What do I get?
Whatever I choose to give you.
Annie!
Kamal? Kamal? You shouldn't be here at all.
They took us.
I know. I thought you'd be at the detention centre by now.
They didn't see me or Amina. Please, Annie, we need your help.
There's nothing I can do.
We haven't been paid.
I know.
We need your help, please. I need to be paid. Without money, we have nothing. I can go nowhere.
I see what I can do.
Can you talk to her?
She won't pay you now. She doesn't have to.
I need Jill to pay me. I won't go until I'm paid.
You can't. It's not safe here on their farm. If one of them sees you, they'll ring the immigration. Look, we've got an old barn. It's beyond the cow sheds. Bill never uses it. Take Amina and stay there. I'll meet you later.
But,
listen
but...
to me. It's all your fault. I just wish the bugger hadn't announced it in front of half the county.
Look, I know Jill. I want you to stay working with us.
Great! I get to shovel muck while she counts some on it. I don't think so.
Talking to the labourers, are we now, Ian?
And you can shove it as well.
Just for once, Mike, can't give it a rest.
Been your Peter marrying our Jill if he'd stuck around.
Aye. He married well, nevertheless.
Divorced, isn't he?
Separated. They might get back together.
I know it's been hard for the last couple of years running that place on your own. No room for a B&B or any of that, I suppose.
We manage.
I still make you a good offer. If you change your mind.
They'll carry me out of Marshlands, feet first. That's the only way you'll get me to leave.
It's all very cosy then, Ted. Capatra tiny feet so soon.
What's that supposed to mean?
Biggest farm in the county, eh?
Aye.
Big profits.
We do all right.
You know, when I leave the army, I plan to go into business, make a pile like you. I hope that'll be very soon. I've got me on.
I haven't seen you in that uniform before.
Not seen you all dressed up either, suits you.
Come off it. It's horrible. The old day has been horrible.
It's a bit much you're down into sometimes. All that grand stuff about giving up the farm to your sister. I don't suppose he told you first. You'll not take it to heart, will you?
It's hardly a surprise.
That's the spirit. Right, I'm off. I'll see you later, monkey face.
Hey, Martin! Hang about.
What?
I was just wondering, have you been seeing Kate?
Why? Do you fancy her? Well, forget it, fat boy, because she would touch you with a dead sheep. Hey, fancy a smoke? What your dad said about you being pregnant. It's not Ian's, is it?
Nope. I knew I was pregnant before Ian came back from Belize. I'd better go.
Can we talk later?
Maybe. Policemen don't relax. You're always too good to be true. That's what Aunt Megan said anyway. Probably why she stopped going out with you.
We were only 12. Didn't realise she was gay then. I got over her anyway.
And you got away from here.
How about you? Seen anyone?
Yeah. There is someone. Why? You interested?
A bit close to home for me.
Bet you don't miss it.
What?
That.
No, not really.
Too much hard graft, too little money.
Yeah.
Little accident with some red wine.
Suppose I should get back in there, see if anyone's drunk enough to start dancing. What's happening?
I'm sorry to stop the fun, ladies and gentlemen. I'm afraid I've got some bad news. As you can see, the police are here. There's been an accident. A fatal accident here on the farm in one of the pig sheds.
What is it? What's happened? It's Martin, isn't it?
I'm sorry, Jill.
How did you know it was Martin?
It's Martin. Something's happened to Martin.
I don't understand. Look, where is Martin?
It's Martin's body we found.
Oh, no!
Hey, Jill.
Wildy, I was wondering how you managed to keep so, slim looking, fit.
Apart from food and that.
Ballroom.
Pardon?
Ballroom dancing, sir.
Oh, you mean like the old soft shoe shuffle, come dancing type of thing?
Yes, sir. I could show you if you like.
No sign of a murder weapon, then?
Oh! Yeah. Hey, you sure do pig'em, Peter, don't you? Do you get it, Willie? Pig'em.
Sir.
Oh, my word. There's a lot of them, aren't there?
Intensive farming.
All right. Is that what it is? Oh. Very dapper. What we got?
Corporal Martin Wilkie. Blow to the head.
Are we sure it's murder?
Oh, most likely. Walloped, left for dead. There are signs the body was moved, probably from up there. Someone, one of the pigs, to mess things up for us. They're about to tuck in as well.
Might have saved the killer's bacon.
I'll do the jokes, if you don't mind, Bomber.
Sir?
Any sign of a weapon?
Not a sausage.
And you shouldn't even be here. As far as I'm concerned, you're a suspect until proven otherwise. Oh!
You liked him, didn't you? Did Ian know?
You know this place?
It's Ted Lowry's. Except Ted just retired. His daughters run it. Megan and Jill. Jill's the one who just got married.
At least the wedding day's going to be memorable. Less pressure on all of you tonight, eh, Bomber?
Sir?
Where's the informant, then?
We don't know.
Anonymous tip-off. Very cosy. Someone did a runner. Got a fit of conscience on the way.
One of the wedding guests.
We best get hold of this 999 recording so we might recognise the informant's voice.
Good idea. Talking of guests, your mum and dad are here, aren't they?
Yeah.
Oh, good. I'm looking forward to meeting them at last.
Dad. This is Andy DL, my boss.
Very pleased to meet you, Mr. DL. Peter's told us so much about you.
Oh, really? Oh, lovely to meet you, Mrs. Pascoe.
Oh, call me Annie.
Annie. And you must be Bill.
How much longer are you going to keep us here, then? I've got a farm to run.
We won't keep you any longer than absolutely necessary, Bill. And you are?
Terry Pascoe.
Terry Pascoe?
Peter's cousin.
I live on Marston's farm.
He works with me.
All right. Now then, any of you go anywhere near the pig sheds this afternoon? Or see anybody who did?
I don't know if I should tell you this, but...
Well, it'd been going on, well, on and off for months. Before Ian and I really got together. He was Ian's best friend, you know.
Best friend? In the loose sense of the word, of course. So, obviously, being Ian's best friend, you wouldn't want him to feel left out at the wedding.
Look, I don't know what you mean. I wanted to make it quite clear to Martin we were finished.
You picked a funny time and place. That was the only reason you met him, was it?
I'm just married, Mr. DL.
And did your husband know about you and his best friend?
No. I didn't think so, but...
But?
Well, he could have found out.
I see. Do you know where your husband was all afternoon?
No.
Do you think he might have killed your lover?
No, of course not.
I think I should have a word with you better half, don't you?
I'm sorry, son. I'm so sorry. What are you sorry about, Dad? Are you sorry Wilkie's dead? Or sorry you're screwing my wife?
So it is true.
Of course it is. He should have seen her reaction when Shirley were dead.
But she married you.
Larry wants our farm, that's why she married me.
You don't know that.
Dad, just take your head out of sand and look around you.
Did you know she was seeing him? You know, before today.
What do you think?
Whatever happens, and whatever has happened, I'll stand by you, you know that. We're family, we stick together.
Ian Henslow, is it?
Aye. He's a bit upset right now. Martin Wilkie was his best friend.
Really? So, lad, this is no way to spend your wedding day, is it? Did you leave the marquee at any time this afternoon?
Yeah, just for a short while.
Time?
I couldn't say. I was changing my shirt. I had to get out my uniform. Bloody Megan had spilled red wine down in front of me. Well, Pete saw me, didn't you, Pete?
Well, I saw you coming back from the farmhouse after you changed.
Was there anyone with you in the farmhouse?
No, I suppose not.
So did anyone see you?
Corporal Martin Wilkie, 29 years old.
We think he died between 2 and 3 o'clock this afternoon.
Have you arrested anyone yet?
It was a break, Colonel. It's only 5 o'clock.
Oh, what was it? Was he in some kind of brawl?
We don't know. You tell us. Did he like a fight?
All soldiers like a fight. Especially at a wedding. Well, Sergeant Henslow did get married today, didn't he?
Yes, Colonel. What we really want to know is whether Corporal Wilkie had been in any sort of trouble recently. Or if he had any enemies.
I don't think so. Well, he and some of his platoon did get a bit of a name for themselves in Bosnia.
What kind of thing?
Something to do with, let's have a look at the file. Oh, yes, some of them were mixing with the local mafia. Turns out they thought they could make a bit of money helping some poor unfortunates leave the country.
What do you mean?
Immigration. People pay good money for EU documents, passports, that sort of thing. Nothing was ever proven against Corporal Wilkie, of course, but I'd say he was a bit of a chancer.
These are the names of other soldiers, past and present, who were at the wedding. Might any of them have a reason to kill Wilkie?
Huh? Not that I know of. Oh. Terry Pascoe.
My cousin. What about him?
Oh, nothing. Never a natural soldier. Poor chap.
Has, Mrs. Wilkie been informed?
Of course.
We'd like a word with her if you could point us in the right direction.
What's he like, then? His cousin of yours?
He's all right. Mum and Dad took him in when he was a kid. His parents split and neither of them really wanted him. He seems happy enough working with me dad.
So, no trouble there, then?
No, but...
Bloody hell.
What now?
There's no one in at the time. Mrs. Wilkie, the lady of the house, being comforted by a neighbour. Her husband's just been killed.
I don't know.
So what happened?
Could have been an intruder. Someone knocked over a gas heater. We're not sure how yet. You'll just have to wait for my report.
Mrs. Wilkie, superintendent of the L. I'm very sorry about your husband. I'm trying to find out what happened to him. But I'm sorry, but, I've got to ask you a few questions.
I don't know anything. I have no idea. I don't know what's going on.
All right, love.
You can't stay here for long, Kamal.
It took us 3 months to get to here from Bosnia. I must have my money.
What about Emina? She's not fit.
I owe it. For my journey. My sisters, my parents, they're still back in Bosnia. People that brought us here, they're mafia. If I don't pay them, my family's gonna get killed.
Well, you'd better wait a day or two. There's been an accident. Man's been found dead on the Lowry farm.
Dead? How? I didn't know this.
You haven't asked me how I got on in the hospital.
Sorry, Andy. Been a bit of a day. How did you get on?
Usual rubbish. Stop smoking, stop eating, stop drinking. Might as well stop breathing. I'll be all right. I'll drop you back at your mum and dad's then.
Well, if you can hang on while I change, I'll come back to the station with you.
No, Peter. You're off the case. You're too close. Your old school friend has a motive for murder and no alibi. And that's just for starters. Your whole family could be banged up when we're done.
Naseby hasn't even been my home in 18 years.
You're on the bench.
Home visit?
Yes, and a neighbour. It's her first baby. You know how nervous these young mothers can be. Anyway, what are you doing? Standing out here?
It looks like I'll be staying on a few days. After all, I can't work on this case, can I?
How's the new flat coming along, love?
Fine. Just need a few more bits and pieces.
We shall have to come and have a look at the place, won't we, Bill?
Terry could look after things for a day or two, couldn't he?
No, too much for one.
Talk of the devil. Just about giving up on you.
Yeah, just been up the sheep bit for a couple of pints.
Peter's going to stay for a while.
Oh, great.
I'll just fetch that bit of washing down.
So, have you and the fat man found the killer yet?
No. And I'm no longer on the case, so I'm not likely to.
Well, why's that?
Oh, too close to home.
What? I think we had something to do with it.
No, of course not. It's just, not right. I mean, everybody knows you didn't get on with Wilkie, and I am your cousin.
Peter, it's not like we didn't get on. It was just joking. You know, he was a joker. He liked a bit of a laugh.
Shut up, Terry. You don't need to defend yourself here. This is a farm, not a police station. You want to go ferreting, do it in the woods.
Thank you.
Breakfast in bed?
No, I'll come downstairs.
Oh, that's social. Unlike some. Oh, I don't allow muddy boots in the rooms. It ruins the rugs, so just leave them outside by the door, and then I'll have to come off. Just the one night, you said?
Yes, just the one night.
Oh, pity. It's plenty to see around Naseby. Mr. Mortimer's been here a week and he's out all day walking the dales.
First and last family wedding I'm likely to see. And it ends like this.
What do you mean, the last?
I can't see either of you two getting married.
Is that all you're bothered about? A man was killed here today.
Wilkie. He's no friend to this family.
What do you mean?
Every cloud has a silver lining. That's all I'm saying.
You're sick.
I can't remember the last time Peter stopped over for more than one night.
You haven't exactly made it easy for him.
He's only here to play at policeman. And why's he having a go at our Terry?
Bill, you and Peter, you're very different. He's never going to be like you. He wasn't cut out for farming. But he's made a good go of what he does do. I think you should be proud of him. I know I am.
I don't mind that he left the farm. I understand that, I do. It's just that all that time we were here with foot and mouth, everything we went through, not once did he offer to come and help.
That's because you'd already made it impossible for him to help. That's the only thing you've got in common. You're both stubborn. I finished it with Martin. It's not my fault he kept pestering me.
Didn't answer the question. Is it his baby?
Of course it isn't. I have told you the truth.
Emin, what's the new old? It's the one in which you need.
What do you want to say?
That doesn't mean anything.
Yes, it does. Yes, it does.
Oh!
Means you and him had every opportunity and you took it, didn't you?
Oh, all right, Ian, if you want to know the truth, I lied. I was still seeing him. You don't honestly think I married you because I loved you. Did you? I married you because of your land. The land your farm brings to mine.
You! You know, it would make me sick. Do you think I brought another Lowry into this world?
Oh, really? Because you wouldn't stand a chance when there were men like Martin around.
You slag! Oh,
just leave me alone! This is my house, Ian!
Get out!
Get out! Oh, no, you get out! This is my house!
Get out!
Oh, little man you are! You have no bloody idea of screwing your own best friend!
Get out!
Your own best friend, Ian, and you have no idea! Oh, what a man you must be!
You don't care about anyone. Or anything but your precious farm!
Oh, God, just get away from me! No! Leave the whole thing alone, this bloody wedding, and just... Stop me!
Get out!
Get out!
Oh, I'm stopping over for a few days. Thought I'd drop by on Ian.
You investigating?
No, I'm not allowed to.
I know too many of the witnesses. Might even know the suspect.
Good. Company. Back to change. I thought you couldn't wait to get away.
You still don't get on with your family, do you?
Always been like that. Jill's bossy. Megan's a bit straight. I meant... You know what I mean.
And your dad?
My dad only cares about himself. And the farm, of course. Jill's only ever been his favourite because she loves the farm.
I know how you feel. How about lift up there, then?
Okay.
Corporal Wilkie seems to have been struck on the head with, well, don't know what. No, probably wooden. Found a tiny, tiny piece of dark wood on the edge of the wound. And that's it, really. Oh, look, fractured skull.
Right.
Oh, apart from those rather nasty wounds around his face, of course, where the pigs had lunch.
Was he killed by the pigs or the blow to the head?
Oh, hematoma, without a doubt. No, the pigs were just bad for his complexion.
So what do you think the killer was looking for, sir?
I don't know. Maybe for Terry Wogan. Something for Auntie's bloomers. I shouldn't have had that extra bit of bacon. Terrible indigestion.
They just don't want to be disturbed. Fair enough.
I'll try around the back.
I don't know. She was fine. Then she got weak. She's tired.
I told you, she can't live like this. I think it's exposure. She needs to see a doctor.
You're a doctor.
No, I'm just a nurse.
You can help.
Kemal, she needs proper care. Rest. The authorities.
No authorities.
Listen to me. You're putting your daughter's life at risk.
I've been doing that since I got to this country. Please. I need you to look after me. Just for a little while. I know how to get the money. Please, just for one day. Yeah?
Jill was out in the kitchen. It looks like she had no work surface. There's blood on the edge.
Have you been drinking?
A row.
I can guess what about.
There's no note. You think Ian killed Wilkie?
Strong possibility now. Jill confronts him. Maybe he denies it. Maybe he doesn't. They argue, struggle. She's it or she falls. Either way, she bangs her head.
He realises he's killed her, comes back in here and tops himself.
Yeah. All very neat and tidy.
How's Kate?
Doctor's been, she's had a mild sedative. I'll be working, Dad.
I'm sorry, Mr. Lowry. This should have been a happy time for your family. Must have been very strained. Their first night as a married couple. Not exactly wedded bliss, was it? After she admitted having an affair with Corporal Wilkie.
Jill wanted the marriage to work.
From what I hear, you both wanted the marriage to work. Jill marrying Ian Henslow made the biggest farm in the county. Did she love Ian?
Jill wouldn't have married a man she didn't love.
I gather your daughter was pregnant. Was there any question about who the father was? I mean, Ian Henslow might have thought twice about killing his own baby. But if he found out it belonged to Wilkie, could explain Wilkie's death as well, don't you think?
I dare say.
Well, work, pigs. Don't take this the wrong way, Miss Larry, but I was wondering, how come Jill got the farm? It's worth a fortune. To an outsider, it doesn't seem quite fair.
My father loved Jill. She's a good farmer. And she was pregnant with his grandchild. That meant a lot to him.
I'm not sure I understand.
I'm a lesbian, and I've never wanted children.
Oh, I see. Silly me. So if Jill got all that, what did you get?
What was left? Cottage. Bits and pieces.
And your other sister, Kate?
I don't know why you're asking that. Kate's not interested in farming.
Laying it on a bit thick, weren't you, Andy? We're not even sure Ian was murdered.
Is that the one you fancied as a kid? Megan?
We were 12.
Trust you to go barking up the wrong tree.
Very funny. Andy, is this now a murder investigation?
Always been that. By the way, has old man Larry always walked with a stick?
For as long as I can remember. Why?
Nothing. Yes, Wildy.
You sure that's not one of yours?
I didn't look through that window.
Well, somebody did at some point. So why don't they intervene or call the police?
Sir, we found this in the bushes.
What is it?
It's a doll's arm. Doesn't look like it's been there long.
Something stinks.
Time of death between 10 and 11 o'clock last night. Cause of death? Single shot to the head, right up through the chin. The gun was fired from no more than a range of 8 inches.
8 inches?
There's tattooing on the skin, but gunpowder particles, but no soot. This man did not shoot himself.
No other prints on the trigger?
No. But then again, there's no residue on the skin. Toxicology also reveal a substantial amount of alcohol in his blood. Whoever did shoot him didn't have to work too hard. Well, I've sent the cartridge off to ballistics. They should tell whether he was killed with that gun or not. Right! I'd better make a start on his good lady wife.
I've heard of a shotgun wedding, but this is ridiculous.
Good, yes. Very funny, Mr. Dio.
So, Ian didn't kill my daughter.
He couldn't have. It was a double murder.
So who killed her?
We don't know. Any ideas?
Oh, I might have. There was a group of immigrant workers up here harvesting the spuds. Immigration came and took them away the night before the wedding, before we could pay them what they were due. Any one of them had a grudge.
They were taken away. They'd be in detention.
They could be. I don't know. I mean, Jill dealt with them. Any of them came after the money.
We'll check. Oh, by the way, how many people have keys to the gun cabinet?
We all did. The whole family. Except Kate.
Where would Jill have kept her keys?
On her key ring.
So if anybody had got hold of her keys, they could open the cabinet.
Well, give me Jill's keys. I'll show you which one it is.
There's only one problem. We don't know where they are.
The work gang we picked up a couple of nights ago from Naseby were mostly Bosnian Muslims.
How did you know they were there?
Tip-off. Probably from the farmer. Crop picking season ends. Surefire way of not paying them.
It's been better. staying where they were, poor sods.
Have any of them been allowed out since you brought them here?
I'll be in trouble if they have.
You weren't too hard on them, I hope.
No, she was like that when we found her. Obviously, somebody must have looked after her. It's a professional job.
How did you find work on the farm?
Ask her.
Kako se naši posao na farmi?
Ne znam, moj muž.
I don't know, my husband.
What husband? I thought you were on your own.
Yes, I am. Vilki. Mr. Vilki. He helped us find work.
But none of you were paid, were you? Where's your husband?
No husband. No. He not come. He not come. No husband.
Look, I'm warning you. No, listen to what I... You listen to what I say. You leave the money where I tell you.
I don't know, Peter, what that family's going through.
I know. I'm just going to change. Hello? Who are you? Mom? Who's the kid?
I tried to tell you. I'm probably doing the wrong thing.
What?
Her father worked for the Lowrys. He's Bosnian.
Well, I thought they'd all been rounded up by immigration.
Not Kemal. He and Amina managed to escape. And he's desperate for money, Peter. The Lowrys owe him.
Mum, you should have told me! This man could be a suspect. There's been 3 murders.
3?
Ian's death might not have been suicide. Do you see, this Kemal's after money. Jill and Ian are dead.
Well, he told me this morning he didn't get his money.
Where is he now?
I don't know. He said he needed more time.
What was he wearing?
I don't know. I can't remember.
Mum, but you can't keep that child here. She's an illegal immigrant.
I don't care, Peter. She's a little girl, and she's very poorly, and she needs me to look after her.
But, Mum, this man could be dangerous, and he'll be coming back here to get her.
He's not dangerous.
You don't know that.
Peter, do you have any idea what these people have been through to get into this country, what that child has seen? If you take her, you take me with you.
Think of the position it puts me in.
You should be a human being first, and then a policeman.
I'm going after him.
Yeah?
Inspector Pascal called, sir.
What do you want?
Looks like he's found our missing immigrant.
Good. Bring him in, then.
Mr. Pascal lost him, sir. But we've got the 999 tape from yesterday.
Yes, I want to report a body. It's in a pig shed.
Can you give me your name, please?
What? No. Look, just listen. It's on the Lowry Farm. That's Old Coal Lane, Naseby.
Is that where you're calling from?
Never mind me. Just get someone down there. It's the first shed's right side, off the main drive.
Caller, are you there?
Anything?
It's difficult to say. I don't want to get him into trouble if I'm wrong.
Him?
Well, yeah, it could be Mr. Mortimer.
It's the other guest who's staying here.
I'm not certain, mind.
Thanks very much, Viv. You've been a great help. I'd appreciate it if you kept this between us.
I just thought he was a bird watcher. You know, coming in and out all the time. He's not dangerous, is he?
Oh, no, not with our wheelie around. He could do with a drop of milk, though. He's a growing lad.
Oh, I'll go and make some tea.
Grand.
Which British singer had a UK number one single in 1999, 40 years after his birth?
Cliff Richard.
Correct. Peter, in sport, a game of American football is divided into how many periods?
Four.
Three.
Four.
The musical instrument
the piano forte
yes.
is commonly known as what?
E. coli. Environmental health people found it in her food. The residential home claimed they bought the meat from a stall down Weatherton Market.
How old was your mum when she died?
77. She should have lived another 10 years. She had 2 sisters in their 90s. No mother reached 100. She got a telegram from the Queen.
So that's why you've been snooping around, trying to track down the source of the outbreak.
You,
It was a tip-off. I got a note through the post saying a farm here was trading in illegal meat.
Who sent it?
It was anonymous.
Have you still got it?
No, I threw it away.
So you came down here to have a look?
And I found what I was looking for. That Lowry farm's a disgrace. The condition those pigs are kept in. I was trying to get some pictures. That's when I saw the dead body.
Why didn't you stick around?
Well, you're thinking I'd done it.
When you got the tip-off, why didn't you contact the relevant authorities?
You are joking, aren't you? I know how the system works. Look at all that mad cow business. How long that took to come out. And it's still with us, isn't it? And what about foot and mouth?
What about foot and mouth?
Well, I think some farmers were only too happy to be making money out of it. Some are even keen to infect their own livestock.
Fraud. Are you on duty tonight, love?
Tomorrow. If Amina's still here, will you keep an eye on for her?
Yeah, of course I will. Daughter you never had, eh? I'll be glad when you don't have to work nights. Or at all.
It's no hardship.
It's not as if they pay you properly.
I don't do it for the money.
I would have gone under if it weren't for that money.
That'll do, Terry.
It's that bad, is it?
We manage.
Oh, I'd have thought things had got better by now.
Things don't just get better when you've been that close to the edge, you know.
I know that, Dad.
No. No, you don't. You're lucky we're still here to come back too.
Well, let me help you then. I want to.
It's too late now.
OK, sir, so it's one, two, three.
One, two, three.
No, sir, I have to leave. You're the lady.
One, two, three.
Is there something I should know?
Took your time.
Thanks for hanging on. I need a drink.
Mr. Patriot, a phone.
You won't admit how hard things are. It's pretty bad. My mum's the only one bringing any money in. You can guess what a district nurse earns.
Well, didn't he get any compensation for foot and mouth?
Didn't get to him. He just missed the cull. Didn't get a penny out of it. Not like Henslow or old man Lowry.
Hey, Tweedy! You're around.
Tweedy?
Harris Tweed. DC Harris. Get it?
I suppose it's an improvement on Bomber. Pasco came to let the cattle out.
We sure he's obviously an immigrant?
Mrs. Pasco identified the body. It's Nada Soldrick's husband, Kamal. His daughter's in the house.
What's she doing here?
We'll have to ask Inspector Pasco.
We got any DNA matches between this fellow and the scene of Wilkie's murder?
Well, forensics are onto it now, sir. But look at the tread.
Is it a match for the print we found at the cottage? It
looks that way.
Question is, was he a witness to Ian and Jill's murder? Or the killer himself.
This might help. And that's not all.
Made to look like a lot of money.
So do you think that he was trying to fake some cash?
I think someone gave it him. Trying to pay him off.
Do we know what killed him?
Beef. Or maybe a Yorkshire pudding. So, none of you knew he was here?
No.
I imagine you wouldn't be too happy having a bunch of illegal immigrants snooping around your beef sheds.
What's that supposed to mean?
Difficult to protect, farm property. A lot of thieves about. Intruders. Do you get much rustling in these parts?
Andy, can I have a word outside, please?
Police matter, is it, Peter?
Exactly what were you trying to get at in there?
Just doing the job, Peter. Well, you're obviously not doing yours. Oh, sorry, I forgot you're on leave, aren't you? I want to let your hair down. harbour a few illegal immigrants, fail to disclose the whereabouts of a suspect.
None of us knew where he was.
How do I know that? Seems to be your whole family's on the block now.
That's rubbish.
You knew that little girl was here, didn't you?
Yes, I did.
And it didn't occur to you to tell me. Not to mention your mother's been harbouring a murder suspect the past 2 days.
She didn't have any idea.
Is there something in the water out here? Affects the brains? And what about Corporal Wilkie? He was part of the trade of these illegal immigrants, you know. Kamal had every reason to do him in. But your mum was too happy to keep things to herself.
This has got nothing to do with my mother. And you can't blame her for taking the kid in. She's a nurse. It's her job. She looks after the sick, whoever they are. And I think she was right to.
I'd like to conduct a search of these premises.
What for?
Who knows what will turn up. Maybe a bunk bed full of Bosnians.
Don't be ridiculous.
I don't have to give my reasons. I'd like to know if I have your consent.
You've got nothing better to do. Well, we've got nothing to hide, so do what you like.
What's on your mind, Andy?
I'll tell you what's on my mind. Your cousin, the Yorkshire Pudding. He knew Wilkie, he knew Ian Henslow, and now he's just a cowpat away from another murder.
Pretty loose connection.
We'll see. Where's his room?
Hey, old Wildy.
Dirty video. Not a bootleg copy of Country File, maybe.
I didn't know it's the video recorder.
I don't remember what's there. It's just... a friend lent it me. It's what? We've got a video player back at the station. Perhaps you'd like to come and watch it there. It'll be handy anyway, because we'd like to have a little chat with you.
What for?
Why do you want to talk to Terry? He hasn't done anything.
Are you happy to come, or do I need to make it official?
Peter, tell him. I ain't done nothing. I never left the house last night.
I don't think you have a clue what you're doing.
Go on, lad. Let's get going.
I'm coming with you.
There's no point, Dad. You can't do anything.
He's family, isn't he?
Well, there's your Terry. What's that he's got?
Looks like a dead sheep.
Who's the other fella?
Well, it's not Dad's land.
Whose is it, then? And what's he doing with a dead sheep?
Who shot the video?
And why? We know Wilkie's house was burgled after he died. Just the tiniest speck of DNA will put you right at the scene.
I didn't mean to start that fire. You've got to believe me.
I'll believe you when I hear the truth. You were spreading foot and mouth, weren't you? And getting paid for it. Farmer's got compensation and you got a cut. Never ceases to amaze me what people will do for money.
You don't understand, Mr. DL. I couldn't stay in the army. But I couldn't afford to leave.
Was Wilkie involved? It was your idea, then?
Yeah.
So how did Wilkie find out?
Told him.
Surely he wasn't the best person to tell. Unless, perhaps, you thought he might be impressed. You should have kept your mouth shut, Terry. You gave him the perfect opportunity for blackmail. That's why he filmed you. Dragging that sheep across farmer.
Yeah, but I didn't kill him, I swear it!
As if that makes it any better. You didn't kill Wilkie. Because he wasn't blackmailing you, was he?
Dad? Terry's been kept in. He's been charged. Several counts.
Well, I hope you know what you're doing. Terry's been a great help to me, you know.
I know.
I can't see him, can I?
Afraid not.
I'd best get on, then.
Dad. I'm sorry.
Thanks for coming, Annie. It's much appreciated.
It's no trouble.
Once again, Megan, I'm so sorry. Can't tell you how much I feel for you all. Well, better get on. Finish me rounds. I've left Bill in charge of the little girl. She starts fretting, you'll be flummoxed.
What girl?
The daughter of Kemal, the immigrant who died. Still waiting for social services.
Mom? What are you doing here?
Ted's not too well. I think it's nervous exhaustion.
Well, you're giving him something strong. He'll feel a lot worse in a minute. Isn't it?
Mr. DL? What can we do for you?
Come for a little talk with your dad.
I'll fetch Dad down.
How are you, Kate?
You know, I found something when I was out with the dogs. Don't know if it's relevant. I meant to give it you.
Where'd you find it?
On the lane, there's a lodge.
I mean, as much as the arm we found. Thanks. It'll be important.
I've been having a chat with Terry Pascoe.
Aye.
And I've been watching a video. You and Terry are on it. Dragging a dead sheep across your land. I've got a statement from him. Well,
it took me 30 years to build this place. 30 years of graft.
What happened? You get greedy.
I bought land. I had to. But I stretched too far and I got into debt. I couldn't give this farm up, Mr. DL. I had to save it.
Foot and mouth is a blessing in disguise, then.
I were only doing what others did.
Some others.
But Terry Pascoe was the wrong man to do business with, wasn't he?
He couldn't keep his mouth shut. He had to impress Martin Wilkie. And I've been paying the price ever since.
So you decided to stop paying him once and for all? You killed him. What did you use? Your walking stick.
I wanted Jill to have what I'd made. I wanted my grandchildren to farm this land. And then Martin Wilkie told me that the baby was his.
Once you realised what you'd done, you roped Terry in to steal the tape. Only he was too clumsy.
Did Terry kill her? My Jill.
We're not sure yet.
I suppose I came from nothing. And now I'm back there. With nothing.
He wouldn't have killed his own daughter. She was the only thing he loved apart from his precious farm. Could he have killed Kemal? Or are we going back to Terry for all that?
It's all in the family, Peter.
Well, Megan gets the farm. What's left of it?
Hello? Sweetie? Yeah? Right. I see. Ah. Well done. Thanks. That was Tweedy. She checked with her dad. He works for the mail. The plastic bag we found the money in. It's standard issue. If you work on the mail. Backing up the wrong tree again, Peter.
Where's Kate?
She went out. What's the matter? What's going on?
She's gone. Why'd she give us this?
Because it confirms what she was worried about. There's another witness, still alive.
Amina.
What are you talking about? Why do you want to speak to Kate?
Oh, Mum didn't mention it to anyone, did she?
Mention what?
The little girl back at our house.
Yes, she did. She said your dad was looking after her.
Here you are. Amina, I brought you a sandwich.
No answer.
Thank you.
turn left. We're in.
Annie?
When I was born.
I know.
Every day of my life. My dad blamed me for that. As if it were my fault.
Why did you kill your sister?
She had everything. Farm. She was my dad's favourite. And then she took Martin.
Martin Wilkie.
He was the only person who ever said he loved me.
But he was married, he had two kids.
He was in love with me! He said he was going to leave his wife, he told me. But then she took him. The one thing I ever had.
Oh, Kate.
Well, seems to have managed without me then.
Just mopping up, sir. You did the legwork. We'd best be going.
Okay. Will do. Thanks for the ballroom dancing, Matt. Not much use for it in here, of course, but as soon as I'm out, I'd like to master my chasse turn action.
Practice it together, sir.
I hope you'll be feeling better, sir.
Just remember. Next time, I want red grapes. in a bottle with a Coke.
I'll catch you up. The doctors reckon you're doing well.
Yeah. Something on your mind, Peter?
How about what happened in that field? You telling me to go on and leave you like that?
You had to. I'm not family. Your dad is. So nothing's between you.
Dunno. He's all right, at least.
Don't leave it, Peter. Your dad won't always be here to talk to you. And why don't you run along? There's a nice big nurse floating about somewhere who wants to give me a bed bath. And I've hidden a sponge.
How are you feeling?
I'll be back on the land soon.
Well, not soon enough. You'll need help. You'll be missing Terry.
He was a great help. But maybe he didn't have the strength of character that you'd expect from a Pascal.
I've taken a few more days off, Dad. I'm going to help out around the place. Don't want you doing more than you can.
We could certainly use it.
Men Behaving Badly, still to come tonight on UK TV Gold. A double from the lads begins next.